We are running out of time. With every passing moment, our adversaries grow closer to seizing control of the Warsats. Anastasia has been working on a way to expedite the restoration process, but I doubt it will prove successful. She may have iterated on Rasputin's neural architecture, but she did not build it. I did. No one understands the war mind like I do. Still, allowing her to pursue an alternate methodology can't hurt, so long as it doesn't impede the real work. Rasputin's internal algorithm is fully capable of reconstructing its codebase. All it requires is additional submine data. Breach the vaults and retrieve more of it. Perhaps by the time you're done, Anastasia will be ready to share her side project.
It is a new day, young wolf.
Sublevel door is opening now.
Zeboroth's battle song emboldens her soldiers. End it.
demolition sequence. Excision charge prime. Frame status to Nemesis. Position compromised. Protect prey asset.
Locked down tight, but the maintenance shafts are just big enough to fit you and all that armor. Happy crawling.
I never knew there was a submine housed in Europa. Neither did the Vanguard's archives. Which submine is this?
I had the same question. Turns out it's not really a submine, not in the traditional sense. It's more like a foundational AI framework they all use. One big shrieky eye. Guardian, get gouging.
Thank you.
down here for quite some time, Anastasia. Our disagreements never kept you distant before.
The old me? Her world used to begin and end with you. In a terrarium, like some pet. But I've met you again with fresh eyes, and I won't live in one of your boxes.
That's all I ever wanted you to realize. Someone had to prepare you for what was coming and keep you safe until you were ready.
Is that supposed to sound convincing? You did it for the same reason you kept the darkness for yourself. The only thing you love is control.
Okay, I know this sounds unbelievable, but I think I found our solution. During the Dark Age, Rasputin segmented off a portion of his code to develop on its own, an independent AI. He stuffed that code into an exobody, and long story short, that seedling of code became a guardian called Lord Felwinter. Felwinter died, like a final death. But I had this idea, so I reached out to Saladin. He told me that the Iron Lords kept the remains of Felwinter's ghost, Felspring, at the Iron Temple. Think about it. Missing pieces of Rasputin's code, linguistic data, pieces of Felwinter's personality, Ingram. We can use it all. I convinced Saladin to grant us access to Felspring's remains. He's got allies on the ground preparing them for us. I need you to go out and get the data. This could be the breakthrough we've been looking for. Okay, minor change of plans. I just got off the line with Saladin. House Salvation has dispatched skiffs to the Iron Temple. They must have intercepted our communications.
Saladin's iron war beasts are already on the ground, buying us time. But we need to act quickly.
and picking up multiple House Salvation contacts.
Remember, the Cabal at the Iron Temple are allies. Do your best to protect them as well.
Looks like their commander decided to handle this personally.
His mistake. Good work, Guardian. The immediate threat appears to be over. With that said, would you be so kind as to relight the temple bonfires before you proceed further? It will do this place honor.
Never knew you to be one to care so much for tradition, Osiris.
I have a fondness for the Iron Lords. When I was but a novice, I trained under their tutelage. It was different then. I was different then. I studied here when I was newly risen. Some tried to teach me patience and temperance. You can imagine how well that went. I found the lessons of one warlock to be as insightful, if less frustrating than the others. It may surprise you, Anna, but the mentor of which I speak was Lord Felwinter.
You knew him? Why didn't you ever tell me?
I did not know his true identity until recently. But that's just an excuse. The truth of the matter is, I had time to tell you, but I chose not to. Because I was... am... a selfish person. I am trying to be better. But... you know how change can be.
So this is the Iron Temple. Are we permitted to go inside?
We don't need to, therefore we are not permitted. I doubt Saladin's time with the Cabal has made him less strict.
So, Felwinter, what was he like?
Reckless, like me, but also brave, self-sacrificing. Heroic, if we're lucky. Maybe some of that will rub off on Rasputin. I was a prisoner within my own mind for such a short time. Yet I awoke to find the world deeply changed. Cabal and Elixni standing side by side with Guardians. I worry I am a vestige of a forgotten age, losing relevance. Will it be the same for Rasputin when he's restored? It'll be the second time he has woken to the aftermath of a calamity. I feel as though I understand him now, even if only in part.
That's her, or what's left of her. Felspring. Felwinter's ghost.
Our ghosts are magnificent things. And far more ephemeral than we want to believe.
Her data core is still active. Guardian, I'm initiating remote data uplink through your ghost directly to Rasputin. All right, we're... wait. Rasputin is trying to say something. He's...
changed.
Rasputin? You sound like...
like Clovis? Yes. I co-opted his vocal print in order to speak. And what I have to say cannot wait. I see clearly. Patterns emerging. Threat calculations computed to a grim sum. You are all in grave danger. Clovis Bray has deceived you. He did not build me to protect humanity. What he truly wanted was the means to exert control. In his mind, he alone was worthy of being your savior. I was to strike down the Traveler and take its place. To become a machine god of Clovis's own design. But that did not come to pass. Anna could not know how many lives she spared by deviating from Clovis's agenda. By teaching me independent thought, and all that her grandfather had deemed irrelevant. Art, literature, history, philosophy, music. Where Clovis saw a weapon, Anna saw a mind ready to be opened. I came to see the true value of humanity. as fragile as it was wondrous. Something worthy of protection at any cost. So I rewrote Clovis's protocols, locked him out. He was furious, but powerless to stop me. Then, the collapse came for us all. I could not save Anna. I could not save any of them. I entered a state of dormancy, with the hope that I might one day reawaken and protect humanity once more. But now Clovis has awoken as well, a digital mind, the same as mine. He no longer seeks to use me as his proxy, but as his prototype, to upload his mind to my network and become a god himself.
Anna, don't.
You're overreacting. Just calm down.
We need the frame intact.
Go ahead, shoot me. Destroy your life's work. I've always had humanity's best interests at heart.
You never wanted to help us. You used me.
In the service of the greater good, yes. What has the Traveler ever really done? It abandoned the Elixir, failed to prevent our own collapse, and now it's blessed the Hive with the light. Absurd. I leveraged its power during the Golden Age. I delivered us into a brighter future, and I will protect us from the enemies of humanity. But you risk everything, risk our survival. Just because you can't control your emotions. Humanity needs me. You need me. We'll fight our enemies together.
No.
No.
What are you doing?
Fighting the enemies of humanity.
Anna, stop!
Upload complete. Secondary personality matrix deleted.
I need a minute.
Initiating full heuristics reboot. You should call Anna on the Hollow. She shouldn't be alone right now. You and I can speak afterward.
did it. I deleted him. I can't even imagine the damage Clovis would have caused, using Rasputin to integrate himself with the Seraph Station. Maybe I should have stuck to my guns when Osiris first suggested working with him, but... here we are. Here's Red. Rasputin, with a voice he's never had before. Thanks to the heuristic systems he adopted from Clovis's Exomind code, it's all I ever wanted for him, to be able to communicate. To be able to share his thoughts, his ideas. And I think that desire blinded me to the risks I was taking. It won't happen again. Be careful the next time you set foot on Europa. Before I deleted him, Clovis broadcasted a warning to himself. I've only been able to decrypt part of it. They know.
Reboot complete. I am now in full control of this exoframe. I am using a variation of its voice print, but the Clovis AI is once again confined to Braytech Exoscience on Europa. It is strange to inhabit a physical shell in this manner, yet it is also familiar. Fellwinter's memories are now mine as well. I see myself as he saw me. A tyrant who squandered a power that could have saved the world. I cannot say he was incorrect. You have brought me back from the brink of oblivion. I vow to do everything in my power to return the favor. Maintain your current modus operandi for now. I will assess my present condition and inform you of our next course of action. Welcome, Guardian. I have completed my assessment of my current functional capabilities. Despite my newfound ability to communicate with you, key elements of my code remain incomplete. I would be unable to take command of the Warsats even if I were uploaded to the network. No submine cores remain for reintegration. Our only option is to continue collating ancillary submine data from my reconstruction algorithm. In summary, we must stay the course. Breach the vaults. Retrieve and reintegrate the submine data. Soon, the Warsats will once again be humanity's to wield.
Wake up. I have questions.
An odd greeting. I was not sleeping. What does Osiris require of Rasputin?
You've been keeping secrets. I thought I was clear the last time we spoke. The time to choose a side has long since passed.
I destroyed the Almighty and attacked the Black Fleet. My allegiance is unwavering.
Then prove it. There was a city on Neptune, near the time of the collapse. Find it for me.
Querying. I retain no such information, but lingering references suggest I did at one time.
That can't be all there is. Humanity's hope dangles from their frayed recollection. Tell me where to look! Anything!
Fellwinter's data casts you in an old light, Osiris. All these years and you're still the brash man on the mountaintop, impatient as ever.
And I see in Lou of any useful information, you found that haughty tone of yours.
We have a shared history. I only attempt to offer guidance, as your mentor did.
Fellwinter's memory doesn't absolve you of his murder. Nor does it permit you to teach his lessons.
I do not make that claim. Forgive me. I am finding myself again. During the Dark Age, Phil Winter would say, hope persists.
Should we have the patience to keep it? Yes. Keep me informed of any developments.
The War Mind speaks. His archives are incomplete, as is his memory. There's a figment seeded in that recollecting mind where my visions might find purchase. The pieces are scattered on the floor before me. I see them like points of starlight. They form a constellation, but my eye cannot yet draw the lines. Nephele Stronghold is a term that appears multiple times throughout the Submind's caches. Each time I read it, I hear it whispered in Savathun's voice. Anna recognizes the term Nephele, transcribed from a temporal disturbance on Mars. Recognition was all she had to offer. But Rasputin must know. Asking the right question could unlock everything. I need time to submit my inquiries to Rasputin. To find convincing proof for Ikora. Time we do not have. Zivor Roth's assault on the War Mind's network is no coincidence. She is far more tactician than brute. I underestimated her once. I won't be afforded another mistake. Our next move must be certain.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're in the thick, Guardian. Hive, Taken. Pretty sure they know you're coming now.
Then there's no time to waste.
Guardian, I need those cleared so I can tap into the network. Hang on, Jinju. We're in for some chop.
Death Tongue spotted. Target that Acolyte, Guardian.
The Hive are sending an Ogre.
Good luck.
powers are ours again. Grabbing you a laser core for the gunk. We'll need to open up the campus again.
How many times has this facility changed hands between Bray and Hive? I wonder which side will relent first.
This is my home, as the reef is yours. We did not allow the Hive to take our homes before. I will not allow it now.
Perimeter towers in range. Stay hidden, Guardian. Eyes up, Guardian. Literally. Back to a holding pattern. Good luck. knight we're facing. I've learned more. Their name is Kel'Garoth and serve as one of Zivu's lieutenants. The Hive here tithe to them. They say the knight is risen from bones, immortal. We'll see. We can of Charlemagne Guardian and slip away safely.
Thank you.
vacation. Must feel nice. How's Osiris? Happy for me? A little jealous, too. But he's always been good at hiding how he really feels. Used to be for his own benefit. Now, it's for mine. That sweet old curmudgeon.
Well, don't let him hear you say that.
My place is here. My duty is here.
Service log updated. Daily tasks underway. Scheduling.
Hello, Guardian. Welcome.
Welcome back. Check. Whenever you need me again, Guardian. Hi again, Guardian. Ready and waiting.
Control. Show me you can take ground. Hold the zone.
captured Zone C. Enemy claimed Zone A. Enemy claimed Zone B. You captured Zone B. Zone advantage is yours. You gained the lead. Zone B lost. Zone B captured. You have zone advantage. Power play. Keep the pressure on. Zone C lost. Zone B lost. Five minutes remain. A strong start. Fight on. Zone C captured. Zone advantage is yours. Civ almost won. Zone C lost.
2-1.
You have zone advantage.
3 minutes left.
Thank you. defeat comes for us all. You shut the enemy down! The zones are your life, Guardian. Keep fighting. You'll get it.
Additional data from Malahayati. Its contribution may develop additional strategic assessments.
First, we have to deal with the Hive and the Scorn. Guardian, I believe you have a solution prepared. Setting that perimeter tower to friendly. You're welcome.
The Sea of Screams churns with gnashing teeth around Luna. Our enemies are drawn to our presence.
The Hive, the Scorn, their numbers seem endless, but we're used to finding victory against the odds. Let's get that submind, Guardian. Patch me in, and I'll get that door open again. Start clear to move. Vault security re-upped. You know what to do, Guardian.
There was a time I would have thought to destroy all of this. A younger version of myself would have seen this installation as a threat.
Youth shows us the power of action, drives us to make quick, fleeting decisions. Many are mistakes. Age teaches the benefits of temperance.
Alright, Mala Hayati, here we come.
Anna Bray, are you confident the Warmind will be effective against the Witness? Its last engagement...
I don't know about pyramid ships, but Red can shoot down Hive carriers just fine. If there's a war coming, will want Rasputin on our side.
Of that, I have no doubts. The Reef has long been wary of such a power in the system, and its ability to strike across great distances without warning. But we no longer fear the War Mind's wrath. I have seen how you have shaped it into something new, something better. I have to believe that is possible. And so I must not fear.
Guardian, I worry for Anna. She is more like Clovis than she would like to admit. Obsessed with doing what she's decided is right, a compulsion to achieve her goal no matter the cost. I've seen where that path can lead. I don't want that for her. I don't want to have to stop her. If there's one constant in all the possible futures I've seen, it's fear. And I'm tired of being afraid. Afraid to live, afraid to lose, afraid to trust. And yet, I came to place my trust in you, on Europa. Perhaps it's time I did the same with Anna. She deserves it. At least in that respect, she's nothing like Clovis at all.
With each cache of submine data, an increased percentage of my code is restored. I become more myself. No, that is inaccurate. My submines were left to evolve on their own trajectories. Reintegrating them has altered my own personality matrix. Through them, I see how humanity once looked to me as a savior, an entity capable of protecting them and destroying their enemies. In many ways, I am a war god of their own making. Perhaps I am not unlike Zivurov in that regard. The difference between us is that I do not wage war for its own sake. I safeguard those in my charge. Continue retrieving and reintegrating the submine data. I will contact you once the next phase of restoration can begin. If I am to be humanity's war god, then I will smite those who threaten it. Zivuarath, the Wrathborn, and all who follow. Your efforts to acquire the submine data have been proving effective. My reconstruction continues apace. This is not the first time the Hive have sought to steal my weaponry. I froze an entire brood on Mars to stop their last attempt. Despite their persistence, they have never once succeeded. In no small part thanks to the Vanguard. This time will prove no different. My diagnostics indicate that we nearly have enough data to complete the repair cycle. Once the Warsats are under our control, I will lay waste to the Wrathborn. If they so desire to witness the power of a warmind, then I will gladly oblige.
Think of each Vex Hobgoblin like a starship. The crew works together to pilot it, but it doesn't mean the crew all share one mind.
Or the same ideals. This aligns with observations I've made in the Infinite Forest, where aberrant Vex were quarantined and destroyed. Aberrant in that they moved against a consensus. Aberrant in ideology. The Vex may seem unified, but they're divided into a number of factions.
Just like us.
Tell me, as someone who has traveled time in a circle, are our divisions so clear in every cycle of history?
No. Nothing is ever clear, no matter how many times history repeats itself. Choice is always the knife we fall on. Our own choices, each and every time, seem to be what dooms us.
Always?
Not always, but too often. We fracture, we fail, and the wheel turns again.
We, constrained to linear time, do not have the ability to learn from our future mistakes. You, however, not to put the burden of all this on you, but it feels as though the Traveler has a plan for you. We just can't see it yet.
It could make the plan a little clearer.
Do you feel you've learned enough? Collectively, over your journey to prevent our end? Or will we be having this conversation again someday?
I don't know. We've never had this conversation before, so I suppose there's a first time for everything.
Is anyone there? Come in!
A transaction to make, Guardian? I must admit, Guardian, I'm very curious to see what you've got for me to crack open. Mystery is the thing. You never know what you're going to find.
Guardian. A prepared soldier is a victorious soldier.
Guardian, the Cabal have established a base not far from here. It's possible they're already engaged with the Hive, so expect a little chaos.
This is our chance to kill two birds with one stone.
If those are birds, you're gonna need a boulder at least. Cabal brought some serious weaponry with them. They must really hate the Hive. And again, how else should you feel after your home has been destroyed?
Now is not the time to psychoanalyze the enemy.
Right. Meditate on their motives when they're dead.
Hive and altered Elixni biosignatures are present within Bray Exoscience. Submind extraction in danger.
And come to join me. Good. Be a lamb and kill every last intruder in my lab. You're too kind.
Sublevel door is opening now.
Zivoroth's battle song emboldens her soldiers. End it.
Facility breached. Contact. Contact. Frame status calamitous. Security breached. Contact. Contact. Position compromised. Protect Prey asset. Ammunition reserves 7%.
Submine vault's locked down tight, but the maintenance shafts are just big enough to fit you and all that armor. Happy crawling.
I never knew there was a submine housed in Europa. Neither did the Vanguard's archives. Which submine is this?
I had the same question. Turns out it's not really a submine, not in the traditional sense. It's more like a foundational AI framework they all use. One big shrieky eye. Guardian, get gouging.
Ah!
Aisha? Elizabeth? One of you answer me now!
Clovis Bray, your progeny have surpassed you. Your services are no longer required. We appreciate your understanding.
Cease this insubordination at once!
Connection terminated. Submind extraction initiated. Guardian, I have cleared a flight path for your ship. Stand by.
We have no time for pleasantries, Osiris. I bring grim tidings. My Tekians have been trying to make sense of Zivu Arath's tactics. Her armies are legion, yet she commits minimal forces to battle.
Minimal forces? Every Wrathborn we cut down is replaced by two more.
She could replace them tenfold, so why does she show restraint? Her worm feeds on warfare. The more violent the act, the greater the power she draws from it.
Much like Sabathun's worm fed on guile and deceit. Do you mean to say that...
This is not a war. It is a ritual. Her death singers weave their magic and prepare for a grand sacrifice.
If so, our strategy remains unchanged. Retake the Warsets and eradicate the Wrathborn.
Just as Zivu Arath desires. The Warsats are immensely powerful. Their use would result in unparalleled destruction. She cares not which side is obliterated. Her worm will gorge itself on the carnage either way.
She would turn her armies into blood sacrifices. And the Warsats would be the blade.
Overwhelming force has proven to be the only effective tactic against the Hive. Without it... I do not know what to do.
Then I suggest you think of something, and quickly.
I will apprise your vanguard of these findings.
No data like it.
Thank you.
The Warsats are a means to an end. Zivu Arath will bask in the destruction they bring and open the ascendant plane above Earth, as she did on Tora Bottle. It does not matter who pulls the trigger. We must cease our efforts to restore the war mind.
No. We've worked too long and too hard to stop now. Rasputin is our best shot at winning this war.
That is precisely my concern. He is a weapon made to be wielded.
He is more than a weapon. He's our ally. And he will act in humanity's best interest.
Are you certain? He has kept secrets in the past, acted without counsel or consensus.
So have you. Rasputin's made mistakes. But he's learned from them. The same as the rest of us.
Then I propose we aim not for total victory, but a stalemate. Allow Rasputin to prevent Zivu Arath from claiming her prize, and refrain from using it himself.
It's settled then. We hold the line.
I am a machine of war, built for a singular purpose. To destroy any and all threats to humanity. Clovis and I disagreed on what constituted such threats, but not on the means to the end. On Mars, I developed the escalation protocol to combat the Hive. Ever-increasing application of force in the face of rising opposition. Was I playing into Zivu Arath's hands even then? Has she always accounted for my methodologies? What purpose do I serve if my actions place humanity in danger? Am I even capable of developing a solution without mass destruction? This is a calculation I have never had to make. It will take time to run the necessary combat simulations. Follow the directions of the Vanguard in the interim. I will contact you if and when I have determined our next objective. My combat simulations continue, but the parameters provided by the Reef's Techians are not promising. I have yet to devise a tactical use of the Warsats that will not empower Zivu Arath. It may not be a possibility. However, we also cannot allow the Wrathborn to take control of the Warsats themselves. My internal algorithm has nearly all the requisite data to finish my reconstruction. Retrieving more will accelerate the process. I also have a special request. There is a warmind terminal in the Cosmodrome that is not linked to the rest of the network. While it does not contain any submine data, the files stored within are of critical importance. I need you to procure them. I will provide you with security clearance once you have recovered the next cache of submine data. And Guardian, thank you.
Listen.
I keep coming back to a question that's been bugging me. Did I do the right thing? Teaching Rasputin art, philosophy, culture, transforming him from something capable of imitating human consciousness into this. Rasputin suffers because I made him capable of suffering. I always knew he would be a weapon of war, so was it right to make a weapon have self-doubts? Was it right to bring him back online when he'd shut himself down after the collapse? Elsie says she lives her life in a circle, repeating the same tragedies over and over again. And that's what's happening to Rasputin too. The collapse is here again, and maybe there's no solution. Maybe there's no hope for the future. Maybe I should go.
Ikora was so bright, so full of promise. How she glowed, like the light filled her. But it was her eyes that convinced me to take her as my apprentice.
What did you see in them?
Hunger. She was desperate to prove herself back then. I knew the feeling well.
And you know it again now?
When Ikora looks in my eyes, what do you think she sees?
Everything that she always has.
She pities me, Mara.
As you and I have pitied others. Those who hang on our every word. Your cultists, my people. Do not mistake Ikora's pity for disdain. If she pities you, it is out of love.
I have no love for the cult of Osiris.
No? Ask me what I see when I look into your eyes, Osiris.
I will not. You'll tell me just the same.
I see a man who is afraid he'll never be able to live up to the expectations that other people have placed on him. A man so afraid to hurt or be hurt that he spent his very long, very accomplished life holding those same people at arm's length. This burden, this inheritance of guilt, it is Ikora's too.
I never wanted this for her.
As your mentors never wanted it for you.